welcome back to another weapons review. As you can see, yes, there she is, the PTRD, the 1941. And well, what can I say? Oh, this thing is a beast, an absolute beast. But in order to make that thing an absolute beast, we're gonna have to set our soldier up for that. And how do we set our soldier up to be a PTRD specialist? Well, dun dun dun, look at the badges. Of course, you got your ubiquitous heavy set and fast reload. You could use those, you know, get an extra bullet in the chamber faster, but we're not gonna be doing that. No. See, that's relying on repetition. We're not going for repetition, we're going for a flat out alpha strike. Okay, and if you're a Mech Warrior fan, you know what that is. Basically, what you're gonna need is infantry first, gold, or Iron Fist gold. Now what these will do, as you can see, Iron Fist will help you take out tanks like Panzer III's, Panzer IV's, Panthers, M3 Lees, M4 Shermans, Jumbo Shermans, EZ-8s. That's what that will do. Basically, if it does penetrate, you'll do an additional 25% damage. Now with infantry first, this is where this thing is gonna become OP. With infantry first, silver or gold, you will one-shot jeeps. So yeah, and bikes, by the way, you will one-shot them. Gone. It still takes about 3 shots to kill an APC, which I think is ridiculous, since how one Haflung and H3 will destroy an APC, or so. Like I said. But you're going to need infantry first. So that's what we're going to equip here today, is infantry first. Now, the heavy set, this is debatable. I know a lot of people would like to go with Marathon Man simply because they need that stamina just to get out of that one area. Oh, your tank spotted you. You need to book it. Your jeep's too far away. Your jeep's destroyed or your bike's destroyed. And you just need to get the hell out of there as fast as you can. I know a lot of people like to go with Marathon Man or Nimble. That way that, you know, your sound's lowered so the tank can't hear you. You know, until all they hear is that bink, and they see a great big portion of their health missing. It's like, oh fuck, oh fuck, oh fuck, oh fuck, you know. I even know some people that go with a camouflage perk. So once they've destroyed the tank, they don't even know where the hell you are. Not bad for a potential sniper build there, guys. So look forward to seeing maybe a follow-up video onto that. But what I'm going to be working with is the ubiquitous heavy set, simply because recons, when they see that long barrel, or tankers are screaming in their chat, help, 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 PTRD, PTRD, PTRD. Those recons are just going to be going whoosh, right into that tank's general area. See the dust you kick up and pop, you're dead. Simply because you weren't running heavy set and they've got that ubiquitous one-hit kill rifle. Heavy set, of course, will not help you against tanks or captured PTRDs, which kind of sucks. Again, that is another issue you're going to come across, because most people, once they see a PTRD, they will run from halfway across the battlefield going, mine, my mine, 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 my mine, 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 my mine, 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 my mine, 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 mine. Literally, it's like the seagulls from freaking Finding Nemo. They just want your PTRD. Okay? So, you can actually use that to your team's advantage. And I've actually done that several times during a live stream with me and 60 Spider-Man, where we've actually won the game because half the infantry literally just seagulled, mine, 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 after my PTRD. And even 60s, we just can't get our head around why. Why? It's like the amphibious vehicles. When the amphibious vehicles got released, everyone all of a sudden is like, oh, I want to nick it, I want to. I just stand there and just blow them up and say, they're a fad. Leave them alone, you cheap bastards. Buy your own. You know, that tends to make them, that tends to ruffle people's feathers. You know what? You know, I don't care. You know, at the end of the day, focus. We're here to win. We're not here to jack someone's fucking car and sail it down the river going, arg, I'm a pirate. You know? If you want to do that, go play Guns of Icarus. Okay? Seriously. If you want to do that, go play Guns of Icarus. Don't play freaking Heroes and Generals. We're here to win. We're not here to freaking sail around on a goddamn floating car or a floating tank going, arg, we're a pirate. You know? Seriously. Come on. That's why I blow them up. Simply because, well, I just want to. There. Yeah, that kind of solved it, didn't it? So, the ubiquitous badges you need, of course. Again, I throw heavy set on. You don't necessarily have to. I know 60s runs Marathon Man and Infantry First. I run Infantry First and heavy set. You could, in theory, run Hoarder, and that will give you three extra bullets. So instead of the ubiquitous 18, you're running 21. You know, of course, Scavenger is still broken. So I really wouldn't worry about that. Tight Grip is not needed because it's not a rapid shooting weapon. It's a single shot weapon. So a Quick Draw? No. Because you're not turning Deadeye, possibly. But again, it's not a fast firing gun. Of course, Grenadier doesn't do anything because it's not explosive. So mostly infantry first. If you don't have veterancy, infantry first. If you do have veterancy, infantry first, and you could go with the ubiquitous heavy set, or you could go with even Iron Fist. That way you're an equal damage opportunist. You know what I mean? You shoot tanks and do serious amount of damage. And you shoot infantry vehicles and do a serious amount of damage. I'm actually thinking about trying an Iron Fist infantry first build. But for now, for the purposes of these videos and the montage you're going to be seeing, it is heavy set and infantry first that I'm using. Now, how do I have my PTRD modified? Well, that's it, pretty much, just bullets. I have the Lenov Monster ammo. That's all I'm running. Now, I do prefer the Bronya Max, simply because the extra penetration value, but honestly, at that range, you've literally got to be up the tank's bum. So if you're planning to do long range sniping on light tanks like M1A, the stock newbie tanks, Stuarts, you're still going to have a hard time penning the side armor and the front armor. The rear armor, I've even bounced off the rear armor off a Stuart using the Bronya Max ammo. Same as Chaffees. Chaffees, you're going to have a hard time penning as well. So who knows? What I plan on doing is I'm going to test out the Lenov Monster ammo today. Also, don't be afraid to take pot shots at planes. Both paraplanes and regular fighting planes. During the live stream, that's over at twitch.tv/DeceptiveCobras, me and a few of my squaddies, we all had PTRDs, or we get, you know, scavenged PTRDs off of me dying or 60s dying, and we just took turns tearing apart fighter planes. Pop, 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 pop. And it got to the point where 60s Spider-Man had shot down over 40 planes. I shot down over 9. Another teammate shot down 6. Combined, we had more plane kills than our fighter pilots. And at one point, even 60 Spider-Man had more plane kills than our fighter pilots, and we had 3 fighter pilots in the sky. So that's something for you to think about, guys. Now, of course, I don't normally do these reviews until I've got everything unlocked, but I am only missing one thing, and that is the matched sights. So yeah, kind of sucks, but like I said, guys, that's the only thing, that is the very last thing I am missing. And like I said, I just don't have the credits to go cling cling just yet, nor do I have the gold. But once I get the very last PTRD specialist out, I will most likely swap out the stock sights for something like either the matched sights or the field adjusted, just something to give me a little bit more common in my grouping. I know 60s also runs a steel barrel. I'm not going to be running it. You don't need the range. You know, it's marginal of the range increase you get. I mean, because look, it doesn't even change anything. It doesn't even change the armor thickness, penetration, or anything. But anyway, I know he runs a steel barrel. I just run either the Bronya Max or the Lenov Monster ammo. I don't run a trigger. I don't run a spring. I don't see the point. I mean, yeah, it will. Actually, the spring does bring the grouping way the hell down. You know what? Here, I'm actually gonna give the heavy spring a try. Bam! There you go, guys. You just saw me buy the mod. So yeah, I look forward to seeing some montage footage of me using the PTRD 1941 here on the end of review. Also, guys, please go check out ForgottenWeapons.com. I will link his channel down below. I'll also, somewhere in here, post a video of him actually firing the PTRD, both the 1941 and the 1942 variant of the rifle. Until then, guys, keep shells flying, keep your enemies dying, your Cobra Commander is out, and I'll see you sexy bastards on the battlefield. Until then, guys, oh, while you're at it, don't forget, leave a comment down below. It's the next weapon you'd like to see me review here in Heroes and Generals. Until then, guys. Take care. and I'll see you on the battlefield.